Liebig's law of minimum. So this law was originated after studying and observing the crop and plant growth. So this law states that the growth of the plants is limited by the nutrient which is in the shortest amount or which is in the least amount, not by the total amount of resources available. Even if other nutrients are abundant, plant growth will be restricted by the one nutrient which is in the shortest supply, often called the limiting factor. For example, imagine a plant needs nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and sunlight for healthy growth. If the plant has ample amount of phosphorus, potassium, and sunlight, but only a small amount of nitrogen, its growth will be limited by nitrogen. Adding more of the abundant nutrients won't promote the growth, but adding nitrogen, which is the limiting nutrient, which is in the shortest supply, it will lead to visible improvements in the plant growth. This principle is applicable in agriculture, where farmers must identify and supply the limiting nutrients to enhance crop yields. Okay, so Liebig's barrel, it is a visual representation of the law of the minimum, which was proposed by Justice von Liebig. So we already understood what this law states. Now let's understand how this barrel analogy works. So you can see over here barrel staves. Each stave or wooden plank of the barrel represents a different nutrient or resource necessary for growth. For example, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, water, sunlight. Now the staves are of varying heights. They are of different heights, indicating the different levels of availability of each nutrient or resource. The water level inside the barrel, it represents the growth potential of the organism or population. It is determined by the shortest stave, which symbolizes the limiting nutrient, means the nutrient which is in shortest supply. The shortest stave, which is labeled as minimum, it is the critical limiting factor. Regardless of the height of the other staves, means regardless of the availability of other nutrients, the barrel can hold water up to the level of the shortest stave. If the shortest stave is too low, the barrel will leak and the water will be limited. Means the nutrient which is in lowest supply, if you will reduce it further, the growth will be hampered. Adding more of the other nutrients will not increase growth until the limiting nutrient is increased. So in summary, Liebig's barrel, it illustrates that an organism's growth is constrained by the most limited resource. To enhance the growth, the limiting nutrient must be taken care of first. So let's understand a very easy example. Imagine you have a barrel that you want to fill with water, but this barrel is made of many wooden planks or staves. Each plank represents something the plants needs to grow, like sunlight, water, nutrients like nitrogen or potassium. Now, if one of these planks is shorter than the others, like this one, the water will start leaking out when it reaches the top of the short plank. So no matter how tall the other planks are, the water cannot go higher than the shortest plank. For a plant to grow, it needs all these things, but if one thing like water is in short supply, the plant won't grow well. Even if it has Now again, this barrel, it represents a system or organism such as a plant. The staves, you can see vertical planks, it represent different essential nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, sulfur, calcium, and magnesium. And the water level in the barrel, it represents the potential growth of the organism, or you can say plant. So the key point is that the shortest stave over here, the phosphorus, it will determine the maximum growth of the plant. Means shortest stave will determine the maximum water level that the barrel can hold. Now, even if other states are longer or more abundant, the overall capacity is limited by the shortest one. Even if all the other nutrients are in higher quantities, the overall growth will be affected by the nutrient which is in the shortest quantity or which is in the shortest supply.